Have you ever Googled your name just to see what comes up about you or what people are saying? You know, Jesus had a conversation like this once with his disciples. He's walking along the road and he turns and he asks, "Who do people say that I am?" After all the miracles, after showing so much love, even after having people trying to kill him, he wants to know, "Who do people say that he is?" And his disciples responded and said, "Some say that you're John the Baptist or Elijah or one of the prophets." But then Jesus asked them directly, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter, without hesitation, says, "You are the Christ, the Son of God." And with that, Jesus has created a problem for everyone. You see, it's not his actions or his teachings that have created this problem. In fact, many people of other religions view Jesus quite favorably as a wonderful teacher or a powerful prophet. The problem is who he claimed to be. You see, he said he was God. And this is the problem with Jesus. He crossed a line that can't be taken back. When you walk around saying things like, "I and the Father are one," or "your sins are forgiven," then you're putting yourself in a position of divinity. It doesn't matter how much good you are doing. People are forced to make a decision about whether you're crazy or the real thing. You see, the most polarizing figure in history can't just be a good man or a moral teacher anymore, because Jesus didn't leave that option open to us. He didn't intend to. Either he was an absolute liar, he was clinically insane, or he was the Son of God. But those are the only choices that there are. So let's think about this for a minute, right? The only realistic explanation for Jesus to lie would have been to gain power. I mean, this is what the Caesars, the Pharaohs, and all others throughout history tried to do by claiming divine origin. Yet Jesus shunned all attempts at this. Instead, he went after the outcasts, like prostitutes and lepers, those without power. In essence, he created a network of people whose influence was absolutely zero. And what about being insane? When we look at the life and the teachings of Jesus, we see anything but insanity. The religious leaders marveled at his knowledge of the law, even as a child. The crowds were awed by his explanations of its teachings. Even those who tried to trick him by twisting his words were left dumbfounded again and again. Considering then the thought that Jesus was the Son of God, what we see fulfilled generations of prophecies written hundreds of years before his birth. We see Jesus demonstrating self-control even when he is betrayed by his own disciples. We see how his words and perfect moral character have influenced the world for over 2,000 years, to the point that we divide history by his birth. To quote C.S. Lewis, either this man was and is the Son of God, or else a madman or something worse. You can shut him up for a fool, you can spit at him and kill him as a demon, or you can fall at his feet and call him Lord and God. But now this problem, this question, belongs to you. Jesus is asking, who do you say that I am?